Good morning, students. In the last lecture, we have completed our fifth schedule. Okay, and yesterday we have discussed about related to these topics. A test also we have conducted yesterday. Okay, maybe you have completed that all, and whatever your doubts, that doubts also we solve. Okay. So now today we will start our next schedule. That is a schedule number 6. Okay, so our total 5 schedule completed, and today we are going to start the schedule number 6. In this schedule, which lesson is there? See, first you open your schedule paper. Okay, in that schedule paper, all information it is given. So in this 6th number schedule, the topic it is given, that is metals and non-metals. Okay, so in this topic, metals and non-metals, actually this lesson it is given in the state board book class 8. So if you have 8th standard textbook, just open it. Okay, so that points we are going to complete here. But which points we will complete? See, in this lesson, metals and non-metals. So what are the metals, what are non-metals, what are the physical properties of metals and non-metals, and uses of metals and non-metals. See, chemical properties also given in that textbook, but chemical properties we are not going to learn now. Okay, so when you will go in 8th standard, that time we will learn about the chemical properties. So this is the important points for you, that is the physical properties of metals and non-metals, and uses of metals and non-metals. And you have to identify which are the metals and which are a non-metals. Okay, so see, in the element, compound and mixture, we have discussed about the all. What are the elements, okay, how the compounds form, and types of mixtures. So elements, you have periodic table also. Total how many elements are present? See, means till now, still it is the discovery, it is going on, okay? But we know that the commonly 118 elements are there in the periodic table. So you have pasted that periodic table in your notebook. So just to open that periodic table, you will see in that all these elements are classified into a 3 categories. Okay, see, these elements, means 180 elements that classify into 3 categories, that is a metals, non-metals and a metalloids. Okay, after this lecture, tomorrow I will send you one PDF file, in that the notes are given for you. Okay, so that all the notes you write down in your chemistry notebook, because especially this topic it is given in 8th standard textbook, but which points are important for us, so that you write down in your chemistry notebook. Okay, so metals, non-metals and metalloids, in the periodic table I have specially mentioned which are metals, which elements are non-metals and which elements are metalloids. Okay, so that chart you will get tomorrow. So now we will start our first point, that is the physical properties of metals. Okay, so you have now idea about what we are going to learn today. So elements are classified into metals, non-metals and metalloids. And now we will see the physical properties of metals. See here the word, it is a physical properties. Now physical properties means which properties? See, in the physical properties, we have to think about the physical state. Okay, then size, shape, and these all are comes in a physical properties. Okay, size is different, shape is different, states are different, colors, textures, these all we are going to learn in these physical properties. Understood physical properties means what? So we have to discuss only the physical properties of metals and non-metals. So now the first physical property it is given, that is a physical state. Now physical state means what? See, you know that all the matter means what? All the things, okay, they are classified into three categories, that is which three states, that is solid, liquid and gaseous state, that is only known as a physical state: solid, liquid and gaseous state. So mostly metals, listen properly, see, mostly metals means all the metals, mostly they are in solid state. Which state? Solid state. Okay, all the metals are in a solid state, but see, some exception are there, means some metals, for example, see here, mercury and gallium. Okay, these two metals are in a liquid state. See, mostly all the metals are in solid state. Only the exceptional case, that is a mercury and gallium, these two metals are in a liquid state. Okay, other all are in a solid state. So this is the first property of a metals. Now second property, see, hardness. Second property is hardness, means all the metals are very hard. For example, see, iron, do you know iron? Most of the times we are using, okay, iron. So iron, how it is? It is very hard. So mostly all metals are hard, okay, but here also some exceptions are there. That is a sodium metal. One metal, it is very soft, means you can cut with the help of knife also, okay. So this much it is very soft, only a sodium. Other all metals are very hard. So today we have discussed these two properties of metals. Remaining points we will continue in our next lecture, okay. So what is your homework today? First, read this point, this topic, it is given in your state board 8th standard book. If you don't have 8th standard book, okay, I will provide you notes related to this lesson, okay, because only one lesson we are going to see from the 8th standard book. So this lesson notes I will provide you, so that notes you write down in your chemistry notebook and read all the points. Remaining physical properties we will continue in our next lecture. Thank you.